Hello friends, welcome to Sandeep's vlog. We are here in Low Bhattu region in BAIJNATH. The distance between Palampur to BAIJNATH is 17 kilometers by road and it takes 30 minutes to reach here. And you are seeing at the backdrop beautiful panoramic view of snow-capped Dholadhar mountain ranges. From here, Lower Bhattu region, we are going to take you to the Upper Bhattu region. Distance between Upper Bhattu region to world-class, world-famous SHERABLING PALPUNG monastery is 6 kilometers and it will take 13 minutes for us to reach to SHERABLING PALPUNG monastery. So let us go to SHERABLING PALPUNG monastery with Sandeep. Here we are seeing flags, multicolored prayer flags. Prayer flags are the cloth printed with formulas of mantras designed to benefit human beings in different ways, such as removing obstacles, granting long life, giving good fortune, and so on. Flags can be blue, white, red, yellow, or green. People may put up prayer flags of 5 colors, alternating, or only one color, according to the astrologer's recommendations. As the wind blows, the prayers are carried into the environment, and any human being that meet the air or breathe in that air are blessed. In Palpung SHERABLING Monastery, there are 15 prayer flags, poles, that run beside the stupas, and prayer flags can be seen there and also at the monk's retreat center. Here, friends, you are seeing 8 stupas. These 8 stupas are large stupas which stand at the roadside of the entrance of Palpung SHERABLING Monastery. They may be the first images of the Palpung SHERABLING for visitors. They are somewhat landmarks at Palpung SHERABLING. The stupa is known in Tibetan as Shorten. As symbolic architecture and wayside shrine is probably the best known and certainly the most distinctive construction. Ranging from simple altar pieces to enormous structures housing large shrine halls. Here, friends, you are seeing in stupa big prayer wheels. Prayer wheels come in all sizes, the tiny ones you find in the tourist shops, the handheld prayer wheels that you see devout disciples using as they circumambulate the monasteries and sacred places, and the enormous prayer wheels filling the special halls. Here you are seeing stupa guest house with restaurant and gift shop, Upper Bhattu, Tehsil BAIJNATH, District Kangra. It's a beautiful piece of Tibetan architectural design. This is Tupa restaurant and gift shop, which is at the distance of 200 meters from SHERABLING PALPUNG main monastery. Friends, we are here in SHERABLING PALPUNG Monastery. SHERABLING Institute, known as Shedra, the 8 stupas, stupa temple, monks retreat center, nuns retreat center, visitors retreat center, monastic primary school, library, craft center, printing and translation center, stupa, prayer flags, prayer wheels, guest house, clinic, lamp house, and stalls. Here you are seeing the dining hall in SHERABLING PALPUNG Monastery. This you are seeing Shedra. And on the right side you have classrooms of SHERABLING PALPUNG Monastery. On your left side we have the main temple of SHERABLING PALPUNG Monastery. In 1975, the present 12th Canting Tai Stupa, settled in Bir, Himachal Pradesh, Northern India, donated a protected pine forested land located in the foothills of Himalayas. They started to establish Palpung SHERABLING, which later became the seat of Tibetans in India. The building was designed by Canting Tai Stupa and is built of modern materials and finished in traditional Tibetan architectural fashion. The concept of the design follows the ancient science of geomancy. Palpung Sherabling cultivates and preserves the artistic lineage of the Palpung traditions. It has 250 monk quarters, which can accommodate over 500 monks, 3 shrine halls, 6 shrine rooms, and all of the traditional and modern monastic features. The main monastery of Palpung Sherabling is built upon 2.5 acres of land, 100 feet in front of the Sherabling Institute. It has 126 monk quarters, 3 shrine halls, 6 shrine rooms, and all of the traditional and modern monastic features. The building was designed by Canting Tai Stupa and is built of modern materials but finished in traditional Tibetan architectural fashion. The main shrine halls overlook a large sandstone courtyard surrounded by monk quarters. The courtyard hosts biannual Lama dances. The protected dances are held at the Kal Chakra calendar, New Year, and the Guru Rinpoche dances in the early autumn. Friends, this is the main entrance of the main shrine hall. And here we are entering into the main shrine hall, which is equipped with 20 columns and a 42 feet Maitreya Buddha statue. The Red Vajra Crown Ceremony Shrine Hall, a 10,000 Buddha hall containing 10,000 gold-leaved Buddha statues, 9 feet tall, a set of 109 volumes of Buddha's teachings, and the 225 volumes of commentaries, 8 6-foot standing statues of Bodhisattvas, and a 7-foot Buddha Sakyamuni with his retinue will look down upon from the balcony into the main shrine hall, 5 apartments for incarnate lamas, offices, and other rooms. Here you are seeing residential hostel for Tibetan monks who study in Sherabling Palpung Monastery. It's a beautiful architectural design made in Tibetan special ancient art of geomancy. At the backdrop you are seeing Dholadhar mountain ranges covered with snow. Here you are seeing Palpung University for the Buddhist Sciences. Here monks are taught about Buddhist traditions and values and their textual content in a typical Buddhist way. They have classrooms where teaching is primarily done by Buddhist teachers. We are here in the lower compound of Sherabling Palpung Monastery, and again you are seeing here 8 stupas. The stupas which we saw earlier also before we entered main Sherabling Palpung Monastery campus. So friends, we had come today to Sherabling Palpung Monastery, located at Upper Bhattu region of Baijnath. I hope you liked the visit to Sherabling Palpung Monastery, a beautiful place. And do subscribe to Sandeep's vlog. Next time, we'll take you to Norbulinka Institute, Dharamshala. The purpose of our visit to Sherabling Palpung Monastery was only to educate the youth so that they may delve into the spiritual power of the Tibetan culture and attain peace and solace.